Okay, so you've spent the whole last unit learning about the normal distribution, and we've always just told you that some data set or some situation is a normal distribution. But how can you tell if you're just given a data set, if you could apply the rules that we learned about the normal distribution to that example? So this is section 6-7 in your book. Called assessing normality. So we want to decide if we have a data set, is it close enough to a normal distribution that we could use what we've learned? And none of this is going to be kind of as rigorous or scientific as you might want, but here we're just going to give kind of some simple things that you can do to see if it's good enough. Okay, and here it's not like linear correlation or something where we have a standard, but we're just going to kind of be looking at it and saying, yeah, that looks normal. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is make a histogram. So you learned how to make histograms in Unit 2. We're going to use our calculators here. I'll show you how to do that. If it doesn't even look bell-shaped, you already know it's not normal. The second thing you can look at is any outliers. If there's more than one outlier, it's not going to be normal. Okay, so in some ways, it's very easy to determine if things aren't normal. If it doesn't have a nice histogram that's bell-shaped, that has too many outliers. Now, if it does have a pretty good, nice bell-shaped histogram, you can use what's called this normal quantile plot. And what that is, that plots every value in your data set is the x-coordinate. You're going to make kind of like a scatter plot here. And the y-coordinate is its z-score. So remember, we learned how to find the z-score. The x value minus the mean over the standard deviation. And the great news is your calculator will do this for you. If that turns out to be a nice straight line with no other patterns, then you can say that it's pretty close to a normal distribution. Okay, so we're going to do two examples here with some data set that you've already seen from Unit 1. Okay, so you'll see I actually have Unit 1 lab pulled up here. And so this first one, we're going to look at the westbound, the ages of the people who are on the Queen Mary on westbound crossings. Okay, so I've already put that into our L1. Okay, I already entered those just so it wouldn't waste your time. And what we're going to do is we're going to first hit your y equals, and we want to go up and turn this plot one on. So just go up to it and hit enter. So when you move away from it, it's blackened. Now to make a histogram, you're going to hit second y equals, go to the where it says stat plot, hit enter here, and you'll see histogram is like this third one. So hit enter, choose the histogram. Okay, make sure this says L1. And then, now, if you just hit graph, you're probably not going to see anything. I do really like this calculator because if you hit zoom and go down to 9, zoom stat, it will pick the right one for you. Now, you can already see that this does not look like a bell-shaped histogram. You could already say, no, these do not come from a normal distribution. Let me show you how you can see the normal quantile plot that we're going to talk about and see that it doesn't fit a straight line. So we're going to go back to stat plot, and this very last one, this one, this is really cool. It's going to automatically make this normal quantile plot for you. And so we're going to leave this L1. You're going to leave X here. This is just what you want the dots to look like. And again, we're going to choose zoom. And you can just hit 9 or hit zoom stat. And it'll make it for us. And you'll notice, even though it does look kind of like a straight line, it kind of has these dips or these patterns, and you don't want any patterns. You want it to really look like a straight line. Okay, let's do one more example. We're going to look at the heights, and we're going to put in these boys' heights that we saw. You know what? Let's go ahead, just because they're a little bit easier numbers, let's check out the mother's heights. Okay, so I'm going to put these in. Heights are something that we normally consider to be normally distributed, so let's see if this data set shows that. so we've got those 20 values in there. Now let's go back to the stat plot and choose our histogram to take a look at it for a minute. Okay, whenever you change these, you're going to want to do zoom 9, the zoom stat. And you'll notice this isn't perfect bell shape, but it's definitely a lot closer than what we saw before. And we could kind of see how it could overall be a bell shape. So let's go ahead and look at that normal quantile plot. Again, zoom 9. Okay, and these still aren't perfect, but you'll see there aren't any little clusters like we saw before. They fall much more into a straight line. Okay, so, you know, if you can answer yes, it's like a bell-shaped distribution, yes, the normal quantile plot is a straight line, that's how we tell if something's normal or not.